help. Yeah, well, I have talked through Two Rivers Alive through a student that was participating with them. I definitely have talked to Bag the Bag, and I've spoken at one of their meetings, and Tiffany Eberhard is my contact there, who we've chatted. And the third, Keep Athens Beautiful at Athens Park County. I have spoken with Kelly, I believe, there, but, you know, I think this tool has been more popular with organizations that aren't, or with individuals, as opposed to organizations that already have a structure in place. Although it is a tool that could make their life more efficient, some people, when their organization has methods and all the volunteers are used to doing things a certain way, I find that change happens much more slowly in that. But what I've really seen in growth in our community is with individuals who now can feel like they're a part of a larger group as they you know, pick up their opportunistically.
Beth, I think scientists are often natural improvisers. I think we tend to improvise a lot in our research, and then we turn it around and publish it as if it was planned. And I'm curious sort of how you study improvisation, and how do you come to understand ways in which that can contribute?
Yeah, well, perhaps I should just say what I did. Actually did some empirical work, oddly enough. I went out and talked to songwriters, because you hear interviews with songwriters on NPR or something, and it's pretty clear that the way a song gets put together is an entirely improvisational process. I'm sure the same kind of thing happens in your lab. So I could have followed you around in your lab, but the songwriters were interesting, so I talked to them. So I talked to them about, you know, how do you put a song together? And I would talk to various different people in a single band, for instance, for different insights on how particular songs had come together. And it turns out that there are some particular strategies. Like one strategy, for instance, is you start with some small bit of something, and then you extend that in a direction you want to go. So that's sort of the analytical framework that I've been trying to develop. You know, what are these little strategies that people use in their labs? Or...
Great.
I want to kind of build off of that question and answer. And so, you know, in a lot of work that we do where we're interacting with this apply, we're often being asked to sort of recommend best practices kinds of things. Trained as an anthropologist, and so my orientation towards complexity and contextualization, I find myself in this kind of push-pull towards recommending best practices that are kind of imply a universal solution, right? And I'm wondering if you have any recommendations for integrating the kind of improvisational piece into recommendations along those lines, because I think it's really important, especially when you're talking about contextualizing, localizing, and tailoring solutions to particular things, that improvisational piece is key.
Yeah, I'm not really sure I can tell you what to do, but I certainly understand the problem, because planning tends to be generalized. So you have a plan, you just give it to everybody and expect them to follow it. But of course, the local conditions, that's why improvisation always has to be included in any execution of a plan, is because the local conditions normally won't allow it to just be executed as written, right? I guess the only thing you could do is talk to whoever you're giving the plan to and ask them what those local conditions are, and do they have any sense of, you know, what steps in this best practice might be derailed by some local condition, and then perhaps you can discuss ways of dealing with it in the particular situation.
I'm also just thinking about building the improvisational space into those recommendations. It's something to think about when people
Yeah, make the recommendations as vague as possible, and people will have to convince themselves.
Eric, could you give us some idea of how large a fraction of rare earth metal usage chemistry and chemosynthesis is compared with other uses for on the planet, like cell phones and making batteries for electric cars?
I mean, we still use a lot of precious metals. We do. I mean, palladium in catalytic converters and cars. Platinum is used abundantly in chemical synthesis, ruthenium for lots of different synthetic uses. You know, I think that there is a general motion to try to design transformations and more abundant uses on these rare earth metals. It is a real challenge because they're so ill-tempered compared to these more precious metals. I don't have fractions for you. It's hard for me to articulate exactly how much, but certainly the precious metals usage is everywhere, and it is a real challenge to address.
Any more questions? Lizzie?
The marine debris tracker, I'm not a geographer, but Omaha, Nebraska, is not really a marine
environment, right.
Is this because anyone can use it and it's cool?
It's because, it can be used anywhere, and it doesn't, because it was originally funded by NOAA as a partnership. It has the name Marine Debris Tracker, it's funded by the Marine Debris Program, but they in no way restrict it to coastal use at all. And so it really can be used anywhere to collect data on litter. And it is right along the Missouri River.
One more.
What are you doing with the data?
Great question. So this is an opportunistic data collection tool, and I wasn't sure how successful it would be, how much data we are going to get, until we're just now starting talks on the statistics that are available to analyze that kind of data. And clearly for initial talks, we need a lot of data in order to analyze it. Certainly we could say something about Omaha, but the global data set itself, really honestly, the more places we collect data and the more data that we have, those of you that know about opportunistic data, means we might be able to do some occupancy models and various things to say, right now we can say we found, certain percentage of plastic, certain percentage of paper. I mean, we've got all the categories of the data and where we found it. So there's metrics, but I'd like to do statistical analysis eventually, but I need more data, probably about 100,000. Entries versus 41.
All right, let's thank this round of speakers.